G'day guys, Fletch here from snowboard.com. Today we're going through a tech rundown on the brand new 2018 Burton name dropper. The name dropper is a park board. It has a true twin shape. It's got Burton's flat top camber profile, which is flat under the bindings, slightly rockered at the tip and tail. It's got a flex rating of 4 out of 10. So it's nice and flexy. It comes in a 148, a 151, a 155, and the 158. The previous name dropper boards have been a big hit with us here at snowboard.com, and we love the super flexy feel you get from the Phileo Flex construction and the awesome pop that comes from the squeeze box and the Triax fiberglass. Add to that the surprising amount of powder float you get from the rocket ends, and this is a really fun board. Another thing we love about the name dropper is the off-axis technology. Off-axis means that a lot of the name dropper's features are roughly set at plus 15 and minus 15 degrees to match the rider's stance. This makes the board more fine-tuned for park riding and assists in a lot of the areas, including smoother takeoffs and landings and better edge hold. Off-axis tech is found in the Phileo Flex construction, the squeeze box, and the frostbite edges of the board. Phileo Flex is an ultra-thin profiling. In the board's thickness, it makes the board softer and gives it more flex. This is paired with a thick sheet of Triax fiberglass in the construction layup, and it keeps the board rigid, stable, and provides a lot of pop that we talked about earlier. Another added benefit of the Phileo Flex is that it's so thin that Burton needed to add pads under the bindings here so that the channel system would fit into the board, and these pads act as extra shock absorption. The squeeze box tech is raised sections of core profile on either side of the bindings. They give the board balanced energy transfer and more snap. The off-axis squeeze box is at the rider's stance angles, so it offers a smoother park-friendly flex. This means that although the name dropper is asymmetrical, it has a set toe and heel side edge so that if you are regular or goofy, you set up the same way. The last off-axis feature is in the frostbite edges. These are protruding edges from under the bindings. Set at 15 degree angle to match your stance, the pressure from your heel and toe contact points will hold a better edge in icy, hard pack conditions. To finish the board out, Burton has added a nice, light Superfly core, Triax top sheet, which adds to the board's pop, and the pre-tuned feel of their Infinite Ride technology. The graphic this year is a gritty, pop art, very stylized graphic. Asymmetrical again, as the board rides both ways. It has a cool grey matte finish. And the base is this pop art sort of thing again. Bold colours and a big set of sexy ass lips right there. So that's the Burton name dropper. It's a soft, buttery, jib-friendly park board full of park-specific tech with heaps of pop. The rocker will keep your nose out of the power and the edges rail hard, so it's really an all-mountain freestyle board for intermediate to advanced riders who want a park monster or a super fun all-mountain charger. Okay guys, subscribe and leave a comment below, or head to our forum and leave your own review of the name dropper. Otherwise, check out snowboard.com for news, reviews, and everything snowboarding. Go forth and shred. I love it.